Awe, awe, se ifai mai sau upu. Betua I ni mala, betua I manu. Sau funa lau pele, sau masina I puhai manu.
Salo falava, my name is Bronson Seiuli, and today we'll be learning how to assemble a traditional Samoan tuinga whau. Traditional tuinga whau is a Samoan form of headdress used at formal occasions. So the tuinga whau is mainly worn by a taupou or a manaia, who are the children of the high chief of the village. Today we have Vaio Tausala Natalie Toivai, who's going to be our model for the assembling of our tuinga whau. And we also have our Lila's Measina team in the back, Mina and Vasa. The first stage of putting together a tuinga is creating what we've got here on Natalie's head. So this is called the bowl. The bowl is the foundation of the tuinga whau. That it's kind of like the anchor that everything's going to be binded onto. So what we've done is we've just taken her hair, put it up into a bun, and then tied it with various different pieces of material so that it's a solid foundation for us to put everything else that's going to go on. Once you have the bowl sorted, you're going to then put on your hair. So the hair traditionally was cut from your ancestors. It may be your mother or your grandmother. This hair in particular, it belongs to my great-grandmother and was cut in the year 1918. So my great-grandmother, that's my grandmother's mother, was born in 1900, and at her 18th birthday occasion, because she was the taupou of the village, they cut her hair, binded it, and gifted it to the village council for use for the village tuinga. We'll put on what they call the lawao, or laulu, and these are four or five tufts of hair that they'll assemble around the bowl. The idea behind having your ancestors here on the tuinga is that when you're carrying out your duty as a taupou or a manaia, you carry the mana of your ancestors literally with a physical memory of those who have gone before you by wearing their hair on probably what's one of the most important parts of the body in Samoan culture, which is the head. And so these tufts of hair will just be getting built around the bowl until we have, it's almost like a wigger. And so we'll keep building until the structure of the hair is quite thick. There are a few origins about where the tuinga came from, how it came to be, but the story I'm familiar with is about a girl who was looking for a husband. And she really didn't want to get married to anyone because she thought everyone was ugly. So what she did was she set out tasks, and whoever was able to do everything that she had asked for, ultimately she would take as her husband. And no one was able to do it, but there was this one guy who came from Manua and was able to go out and find the fish that she was looking for. He wasn't the best looking guy. And so what he did was he grabbed some coconut husks, because he was bold, and used it as his hair. He grabbed some launiu, or some midrib of the coconut palm leaf, and some shells. And he put together this headdress to disguise his face, so that when he was going to present the fish to his, well, potential fiance, that she wouldn't sort of look at how nice he didn't look, but more at the disguise. And so the disguise was what we now call the tuinga. And so what we're gonna do now is we're just going to try and fasten the stuff. So this part up here, with the three sticks and the shelves, is what we call the labe. Trying my best to fasten the labe to the bowl. Quite difficult to when taupou, manaia, whoever is wearing the tuinga has short hair, because we don't really have much to work with, but we'll try our best. And then we'll chuck on what they call the palefuyono. So the palefuyono just sits above the forehead and was traditionally made using the nautilus shell, which I don't think we're native to Samoa, but we would get them imported from Tonga. In the last 5 years, there were very few people who still retain the knowledge of assembling a tuinga whau, let alone making the lawe and all the other pieces that go into creating the tuinga whau. It's the one physical form or material form of our culture that when we see a tuinga, we know it's ours, we can claim it right there and then. And even within our own families, once the tuinga is present, we are all one because we've all come together for one single purpose, which is whatever event that the tuinga is being used for. We started off with the pou, followed by the pou were the lawao or the laulu, followed by this part here, which is the lawe. So the lawe you can decorate with any shells. A lot of people nowadays use mirrors. And then we've got our pale fuiono, which is the headband here, made from the Nautilus shells that were imported from Tonga. And there you go, that's how you assemble the traditional Samoan tuinga whau.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.